So hello students, so in my previous video I was talking about so this particular thing. So all these things we have seen, like axial component and radial component and a tangential component, and three different things that we have seen in my previous video. And this video, so I'm going to explain the Euler's turbine equation. This is what the Euler's turbine equation, which I'm going to explain. This is very, very important for your examination point of view. Okay, Euler's turbine equation is very important. So before that, we will see the different notations, like V is equal to absolute velocity of the fluid in meters per second. So when water, which is coming out from the jet of vein with V velocity, so that is nothing but absolute velocity. So water entering and before hitting the turbine blade, so with absolute velocity it comes. And after hitting, when it goes out at the exit, so it moves out with the absolute velocity V2, that is absolute velocity at exit. So V is equal to absolute velocity of the fluid, meters per second. If it is inlet, V1, or if it is exit, that is V2. So next one is N, capital N is equal to speed of rotation of the rotor. Okay, so there will be a shaft and there will be rotor on top of it. So what is the speed of the rotor when blade, turbine blades rotate, the impeller rotate, then shaft rotates, so the entire rotor will rotate. So what is the speed of the rotor? That is indicated by capital N. Capital N is nothing but speed of rotation of the rotor, which is in RPM, revolutions per minute. So now coming to this R, small r is equal to radius of the rotor. For example, right, so just imagine that this is a circular one, circular position, circular component, and when it is rotating, so small r is nothing but the radius of the rotor, this is the radius, this is nothing but small r. If it is a circular one, so from the center point, so this is nothing but this small r, that is radius of a motor, a rotor, sorry, say radius of the rotor, which is calculated by meters, m, okay, and then omega, angular velocity of the rotor, radians per second, okay. So earlier speed of the speed of rotation of the rotor is RPM, revolutions per minute, how many revolutions per minute. Now this is angular velocity, okay. Earlier absolute velocity capital V, that is a linear velocity. Now coming to this omega, omega is nothing but angular velocity. With what velocity this rotor is moving, this is called angular velocity. Angular velocity of the rotor, that is radians per seconds, that is equal to 2 pi n by 16. Okay, next small u is nothing but linear velocity of vane tip, that is peripheral velocity, that is meters per second, which is taken by pi d n by 16. Linear velocity. Now we have seen absolute velocity and we have seen this angular velocity. So if angular velocity, since this vertical rotor is rotating, if we have taken the angular velocity, if it is the movement of the rotor, if we taken in linear position, that is nothing but linear velocity of the vane tip. Okay, otherwise one more name is called as the tangential component of the absolute velocity. Tangential component of the absolute velocity is nothing but this linear velocity. Linear velocity of vane tip, peripheral velocity, meters per second. So this U has got different names. It can be tangential component of absolute velocity, or linear velocity, or peripheral velocity. So these three names can be given to this particular letter U. Okay, U is nothing but linear velocity, tangential component of absolute velocity, and peripheral velocity, meters per second, which is pi d n by 16. Next one is m dot. M dot is equal to mass flow rate of a fluid, which is nothing but kg per second. So kg per second, mass flow rate, mass is nothing but m. M dot is nothing but mass flow rate, that is kg per second. The last one is d, small d is a rotor diameter. For example, this is rotor and this is the diameter of the rotor, which is taken in meters. Okay, diameter of the rotors in meter. Now coming to this Euler's turbine equation. So first one is the tangential momentum of a fluid at entry. So what is the tangential momentum of the entry, which is nothing but Vw1, that is viral velocity. Vw is nothing but viral velocity. So Vw1 into m, mass flow rate, will give you the tangential momentum of a fluid at entry. okay. And next, angular momentum, momentum of momentum at entry, angular momentum at entry is equal to vw1 m dot into r1. So tangential momentum is for linear one. If you multiply with r1, radius 1, r1, that will become angular momentum. Angular momentum at entry, vw1 into m dot into r1. Then the same way, angular momentum at outlet, that is equal to vw2 m dot into r2. Okay, then T is equal to torque of the rotor. Torque on the rotor, that is nothing but change of angular momentum. Torque, how do we get it? So change of angular momentum only is nothing but torque. That is equal to Vw1 R1 minus Vw2 R2 into m dot. Okay, now coming to this work done. Rate of energy transferred, that is equal to T into omega. Torque into angular velocity is nothing but work done. So in that way, if you write Vw1 R1 minus Vw2 R2 into m dot into omega will give you the work done. But we know that omega 1 R1 is equal to U1 and omega 2 R2 is equal to U2. So therefore, so omega angular velocity and radius is nothing but your linear velocity or peripheral velocity. Okay, so U1 is equal to omega 1 into, so that's what I told you, angular velocity into radius is, will become U1. So omega 2 R2 is nothing but U2. Therefore, work done is equal to Vw1 U1 minus Vw2 U2 into m dot. Okay, so this is the work done formula. Now coming to this work done per unit mass flow rate is nothing but Vw1 U1 minus Vw2. So if it is for unit mass, so here we have taken for some amount of mass, for work done per unit flow rate is nothing but Vw1 U1 minus Vw2 U2. So that is the equation number 2. So now equation 1 and 2 are two forms of Euler turbine equation or Euler equation. So here if you multiply with m, so for some amount of mass flow rate, if you remove that m dot, it will give you for a per unit mass flow rate. Okay, so Euler equation applies to all turbo machines like pumps, fans, blowers, compressors and turbines, steam turbines or gas turbines or water turbines. So it can be applied for all these areas, pumps, fans, blowers, compressors and turbines, okay, different types. Now if the conditions, now again, if Vw1 U1 is greater than Vw2 U2, the RHS of equation 2 is positive, then the machine is called a turbine. For example, Vw1 U1. So our equation is Vw1 U1 minus Vw2 U2. For example, if it is greater than Vw2 U2, then it is called as turbine. Okay, this is a positive one. Suppose if Vw2 U2 is greater than Vw1 U1, then it is negative. Then the machine is called a pump, fan, blower or compressor. Okay, if Vw1 U1 is greater than Vw2 U2 and Vw2 is negative, that is Vw2 is opposite to that of Vw1, then equation can be written as work done per unit mass flow rate is equal to Vw1 U1 minus of minus Vw2 U2, that is equal to Vw1 U1 plus Vw2 U2. So this is how we can write the Euler's turbine equation. Okay, this is what the Euler's turbine equation is all about. So Vw1 U1 minus Vw2 U2, okay, into mass flow rate. Okay, so that will be give you the Euler's turbine equation. Okay, thank you very much.